Hey guys, so I've now made like 4 videos talking about my favorite boss fights in Metal Gear franchise. And I thought to do the opposite, starting with, so this is probably going to be many videos too, but these are my lowest 10 boss fights in the series, in the Metal Gear games that I played. As I mentioned before in the other videos, there's 2 Metal Gear games that I have not played myself, which is Metal Gear Solid Ghost Babel for Game Boy Color and Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. Those are the 2 Metal Gear games I have not played, so I can't really speak about any of the boss fights in there, but I don't think those boss fights will make it into this list, which is my least favorite boss fight. So the order is going to be, number 10 is going to be like, it's going to go from bad to the worst. So number 1 worst would be like my least favorite boss fight in the series. So number 10 for me is the Fear from Metal Gear Solid 3. It's a very annoying fight, especially if you get the so there's no issue of this anymore, but if you played Metal Gear Solid 3, the first version that it was released, Snake Eater, it had a fixed camera angle. Very difficult, because Fear is like on top of the trees, all just flinging around, and it was just a really annoying boss fight. Now there are some cool elements to this boss fight, which is why it's you know, I don't really not like it that much, but it's definitely one of my least favorite boss fights. Really cool element, you can feed poison dart frogs to the Fear, and that affects him. But yeah, the character is just kind of weird, just kind of floats around. You know, if you stamina kill this guy, you can get a really cool camouflage, although, you know, that's always going to give you an 80% camo index at the cost of your stamina going down really fast. So the camouflage has a very, like, cost-benefit thing to it. So, I don't know, I never really used it that much, but it's just the Fear. Like, it was an interesting boss fight to have, I suppose, but it can be extremely annoying to fight him. And because he uses stealth camo, like, most of the time you have your thermal goggles on, and that's just not very fun to play the game with the thermal goggles on. So that's why he's number 10 on this list. Number 9 for me is also another boss from Metal Gear Solid 3. So it's interesting, you know, Metal Gear Solid 3 has some of the best boss fights, but it also has some of the worst boss fights to me. Because the characters don't get developed all that well in this game. You know, they're just the bosses that you fight. There's really hardly any explanation other than, you know, oh, they're the Cobra unit or whatever. But number 9 for me is the Pain. Like, I mean, it's a cool concept, a guy who controls hornets, right? But the boss fight itself is it's pretty simple. You know, you hide underwater, you come up, you shoot a shotgun to his face, and then you make a headshot. But making a headshot with this guy is kind of annoying, because he does this twirl thing when you're aiming at him, and he does this, you know, to dodge your headshot. And if you're trying to stamina kill this guy, that's so frustrating. Like, stop doing that. And then you have to keep using grenades to get the hornets off of him. This boss fight is a fight of attrition. And I don't really like, you know, all the boss fights are kind of fights of attrition, but this one markedly so, and it's just not very fun. So that's why Pain is number 9 for me. Number 8. Many of you guys have not played the PSP games, but I played a lot of portable ops. Number 8 for me. Sorry. I was looking at the wrong list there. Sorry. Number 8 for me, Raging Raven from Metal Gear Solid 4. It's just not a fun fight. I think this is the worst boss fight in Metal Gear Solid 4. I wouldn't say it's the worst boss fight in the series, but it's just, you know, you're in a very cramped area, and the boss is flying around. You have to take out the flying enemies. It's very difficult to aim, to get the aiming right, to get them down, and she's just throwing barrages of grenades at you, because he has a grenade launcher. it's not a very interesting fight. You know, you go up the top floor and you fight her that way. If you're inside the building, you know, in the lower floors, it's just too challenging, you know, because she'll just swoop in and it's just like, so even though it's more fun to fight in the building, it's just kind of really, really annoying. The only cool part is when she gets so mad and she gets so heated up, she'll rest on top of the roof. And you'll find her and you just snipe her right there. That's the only cool part to this boss fight. Otherwise, this boss fight is just boring. I did not like boss fight against Raging Raven. I definitely think it's just the worst boss fight in Metal Gear Solid 4. And I'm looking at my list. That's the only boss for Metal Gear Solid 4 in this list. So that's Raging Raven. Which I guess I liked a lot of the boss fights in Metal Gear Solid 4. I guess Raging Raven was just one of the worst. So number 4 for me is Fat Man from Metal Gear Solid 2. So I don't know, like, there's a kind of a love and hate relationship between me and Fat Man. Like, on the one hand, it's a cool concept. You get to defuse bombs while fighting him. But that in itself is annoying. Like, I'm just going around defusing bomb and he just roller skates by and, you know, you have to shoot. There's not much to this boss fight. You just run around, defuse bomb, shoot a bunch of stuff to Fat Man, make him fall down and make a headshot. On the harder difficulties, this boss fight is extremely frustrating because the timer, the amount of time that you're given to defuse the bombs is reduced. So and there's more bombs. He plants more bombs in a harder difficulty. So there's a little tweak, which makes it extremely more challenging. But I don't think this fight is necessarily like challenging, but just really annoying. Metal Gear Solid 2 also had a boss fight that I like even less than Fat Man, and that's Fortune, if you even call it a boss fight. And that's number 5 for me. Fortune, you just pretty much just run around the place trying not to get hit. And that's pretty much the boss fight. I understand the concept is to introduce this character as, you know, like, whatnot. But it's just not fun. So, like, story-wise, it makes sense. But it's not a boss fight that I want to replay over again. But you have to if you're replaying the game for different rankings and whatnot. Number 6 for me is also from Metal Gear Solid 3, the Shagohod. Seriously. Shagohod is like, it's not even a Metal Gear, technically. So there is no Metal Gear in Metal Gear Solid 3. Except, who's that Russian name? That guy who is pretty much the grandfather of Metal Gear Rex. He has a prototype for Metal Gear. But Grozny, I think his name starts with a G. I forgot. Freaking am forgetting characters' names. But Shagohod is not a Metal Gear, it's just a turbocharged tank that needs a runway to shoot a nuclear missile. The qualification of a Metal Gear is the ability to launch a nuclear missile from any surface of the planet. Shagohod is clearly not capable of that because it requires a runway. The boss fight against this thing, it's just weird. You know, you're on top of the, you know, you're riding on a motorcycle with Eva, and you shoot the rocket launcher like crazy to its core, and shoot the back of the thing, that damages it. And then afterwards, the stage 2, Bulgan is controlling the Shagohod, and you have to make a headshot on him, or damage him in some way. Just meh. You know, I really did not like the fact that, you know, Shagohod is what it is, and the boss fight is not even that interesting or that fun, at least in my opinion. But it was just disappointing, like, that this is the mech boss battle in a Metal Gear game. That's probably why it's number 6. It's so high. I don't like it less than the other bosses, you know. Like, Raging Raven is annoying, but at least, you know, I don't have that high expectation of a boss. Whereas Shagohod is like this big thing in Metal Gear Solid 3, so I do have that high expectation, but the boss fight itself is just eh. So those are, I'm going to stop the video here and continue on with the rest of my list in the next video. But just as a recap, number 10 for me is The Fear. Number 9, The Pain. Number 8, sorry, I have the list backwards. So number 10 is The Fear. Number 9 is The Pain. Number 8 is Raging Raven. Number 7 is Fat Man. Number 6 is Fortune. And number 5 is Shagglehead. Shagglehot, sorry. And yeah, I'll continue in the next video. Cheers.